In thymic hypoplasia, thymic refers to the thymus, which is an immune organ that sits between the lungs. Hypo refers to under, and plasia refers to development. So thymic hypoplasia is a condition where the thymus is underdeveloped and has a reduced number of cells. By week 4 of development, the embryo takes on a more recognizably human form. But to be honest, it still looks more like a shrimp than a baby. At the head end of this little shrimp-like creature, a set of structures called the pharyngeal apparatus starts to develop, consisting of pharyngeal arches, clefts, and pouches. The components of the pharyngeal apparatus develop into various head and neck structures, and sometimes multiple arches join together to give rise to a single structure. Now, the epithelial tissue of the embryo's third and fourth pouch turns into the inferior parathyroid glands, as well as the superior parathyroid glands, while the epithelial tissue that lines the ventral regions of the third pouch forms the thymus. Both glands then go on to break off from the pharyngeal wall and eventually attach to the posterior side of the thyroid. The thymus, now free, migrates down the middle of the pharynx until it ends up in its final position in the front of the thorax, where it fuses with its counterpart from the opposite side. During childhood, the thymus occupies considerable room behind the sternum, in a part of the chest known as the mediastinum, a space in the chest between the lungs that also contains the heart. But when people get older, it atrophies and is replaced by fatty tissue. It's here in the thymus where certain immune cells from the bone marrow mature into T lymphocytes, or just T cells, where the T stands for thymus. Once mature, these T cells help defend the body against infections by activating other cells of the immune system, as well as checking the body's cells for viral infection or abnormalities like cancer. In thymic hypoplasia, a small portion of chromosome 22 is deleted in a condition known as DeGeorge syndrome, or 22q11.2 deletion syndrome. On chromosome 22, there's a gene called TBX1 that controls the development of the third and fourth pharyngeal pouch during the prenatal period. So when there's a 22q11.2 deletion, there's no TBX1 gene, and the thymus and parathyroid glands end up underdeveloped. In thymic hypoplasia, the immature T cells from the bone marrow don't have a place to go to mature, and so these people often have a deficiency in mature T cells. The parathyroid glands also remain underdeveloped. Normally, it secretes parathyroid hormone, which promotes the absorption of calcium in the intestines as well as kidneys while breaking down bones to release more calcium into the blood. But when the parathyroid glands are underdeveloped, there's less parathyroid hormone, which results in hypocalcemia. Thymic hypoplasia also happens in people with ataxia telangiectasia syndrome. And there it's caused by a defect in the ATM gene, or ataxia telangiectasia mutated gene, found on chromosome 11. The ATM gene encodes a protein whose job is to recognize DNA damage and activate proteins to fix the damage. Another function of the gene is to maintain the distal portion of our chromosomes called telomeres. These telomeres protect the ends of the chromosome from degeneration, and when the telomere becomes too short, the chromosome can no longer become replicated. In ataxia telangiectasia syndrome, rapidly dividing cells like thymic cells die prematurely, which leads the thymus to atrophy. Motor neurons in the cerebellum also die prematurely, leading to uncoordinated muscle movement called ataxia. Just like in DeGeorge syndrome, T cells don't have a place to mature, and so these people become deficient in mature T cells, making them susceptible to infections. In ataxia telangiectasia syndrome, unlike DeGeorge syndrome, the parathyroid glands develop normally and secrete normal levels of parathyroid hormone, which results in normal calcium levels in the blood. Early symptoms of thymic hypoplasia are repeated infections due to a T cell deficiency, which results in a weakened immune system. In DeGeorge syndrome, there are also symptoms caused by hypocalcemia, which include osteoporosis and tetany, or involuntary contraction of the muscles. Other symptoms associated with this disorder are congenital cardiac defects like tetralogy of Fallot, cleft palate, and learning disabilities. In ataxia telangiectasia, there can also be symptoms like ataxia, which is a problem with muscle coordination, telangiectasia, which are dilated blood vessels in the skin and eye, and an increased risk of cancer. Diagnosing thymic hypoplasia often starts with genetic testing, which can help identify if it's DeGeorge syndrome or ataxia telangiectasia syndrome. And certain blood tests looking for T-cell numbers and function can help determine the cause of recurrent infections. Also, calcium levels in the blood might hint at two conditions associated with thymic hypoplasia. In DeGeorge syndrome, there's hypocalcemia, while in ataxia telangiectasia, there's normal levels of calcium, or eucalcemia. Antibiotics might be used to treat infections from thymic hypoplasia. Surgery might be required for more severe cases, though, like a thymus transplant. Alright, as a quick recap, thymic hypoplasia is a condition where the thymus is underdeveloped, leading to a reduced number of T cells. There are two main causes of thymic hypoplasia, DeGeorge syndrome and ataxia telangiectasia syndrome, both of which cause a reduction of thymic cells. In DeGeorge syndrome, the parathyroid glands are underdeveloped as well, and this results in less parathyroid hormones, which results in hypocalcemia. On the other hand, in ataxia telangiectasia syndrome, the parathyroid glands develop normally, and this results in normal levels of parathyroid hormones, which results in normal levels of calcium in the blood.
Hey everyone! Thanks so much for watching. I'm hoping our breakdown in this video was useful in helping you understand the inner workings of thymic hypoplasia, especially when differentiating between DeGeorge syndrome and ataxia telangiectasia syndrome. They're kind of similar, but also not, so good to know the difference between them. People who were involved in making this awesome video was Brittany, who did the super cool illustrations, Tanner, who did the voiceover, me, who did the video editing, Miguel, who was the scriptwriter, and Rishi and Yifan, who were the script editors. Thanks so much for watching and always supporting us, and I'll catch you on the next one. See ya!